a broken sky, traced out by the city lights. My world from a mile high, best seat in the house tonight. Touchdown in the cold black tie, hold on for the sudden star. Breathe in the familiar shock of confusion and chaos. All those people going somewhere. Why have I never cared? Give me your eyes for just one second. Give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity. Give me your arms for the brokenhearted, the ones that are far beyond my reach. Give me your heart for the ones forgotten. Give me your eyes so I can see. Yeah. 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 Step out on a busy street, see a girl.
This organization was started actually 29 years ago. It was started by one individual who, actually he's from Long Beach. He was raised in Lakewood and was a realtor in Long Beach and Lakewood area. Made a lot of money and wanted, I think that was the answer to having a great lifestyle. And he turned 30 and he was an alcoholic. His heart and soul were empty and he realized there was more to life. So he got clean and sober and wanted to do something now. And so he went to Cambodia, and he was in Cambodia for the UN and found it to be very rewarding. He got out of himself and really found it just so rewarding. And I came back to Long Beach and wanted to continue. And he thought, I do those things overseas. I need to do something in my own backyard. He was driving down 3rd Street in Long Beach and found this building and thought, wow, maybe I could do something with that building. It was for rent at the time. So he went to the food bank locally here in Long Beach and got food and started serving food to the homeless. And that's how it all began 29 years ago.
Our eyes meet, does the best to smile at me, to hide what's underneath.
I never met Jack Jensen. He passed away before I came to COA. But I think that the work that he started is wonderful. It's incredible how many people just that man has affected. And is still affecting now past the time where he's living, because COA serves food to the homeless, they give clothing, they provide us homes while we obtain education, so they're bettering our lives, our children's lives, and so on down the line. So because of his generosity, he's affected a multitude of people.
Give me your heart for the ones forgotten. Give me your eyes so I can see.
We have a golf tournament, which we just finished, and we have a fall event. It's a dinner and a silent auction, and we're going to add maybe another
one. 1 million eyes just moving past me by. I swear I never thought that I was wrong. Well, I want a second glance, so give me a second chance to see the way you see the people all along. Give me your eyes for just 1 second. Give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity. Give me your arms for the brokenhearted, the ones that are far beyond my reach. Give me your heart for the ones forgotten. Give me your eyes so I can see. Give me your eyes, Lord, give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity. Give me your heart.
I came to COA 4 years ago with my son. Prior to coming to COA, I was a drug addict for 12 years. When I was 25 years old, I found that I was pregnant, and I went to a shelter to get help. And I stayed in a shelter in Hollywood for about a year, and then it was a year in duration. So at the end of that time, my case manager helped me find COA. COA enables me to go to college. They provide us a 2-bedroom, 2-bath apartment at a reduced rate. So I'm able to provide a home for my son while I'm obtaining an education for myself.
And registered, sat down for a minute, got my blood pressure, which is a little bit better, should be a little bit better. Then somebody sat down and talked to us about family services. Then I went on and got pampered. My nails done, my hand massaged. Then I got some clothes, I got a handbag with goodies all inside. I've just had a wonderful day. Everybody's been so great.
Dresser for 20 years, and wow. I've been married and retired from work. Oh, okay. Well, I work, but not hairdressing. I work raising two teenage children and taking care of an invalid father and a husband. So it just blesses me to see them be blessed. God is good.
And we come to this COA because it's so filling for us to give. We see lots of celebrities on television, and they get lots of things when they go to these events, these good events. They get thousands of dollars. Well, we're thrilled that these women are getting goodie bags for things they would never really be able to afford to buy. And we're glad we got wonderful donations, and it's a great day for us.
Feed and clothe everybody, take care of the community service workers, take care of the office ladies upstairs. Hopefully they'll take a good sense of mind that there are people out here who do care about them and like to see the best things for them.
I've been coming to COA for about 2 years. It's serving lunch once a month through Park Rest Christian Church in Long Beach. And this was really an opportunity for me to take what I do for a living, which is test hearing and fit hearing aids, and bring it down here and kind of combine a passion I have for COA with what I do. And I have been an audiologist for 28 years. They contacted me to see if I could get some of the members of Park Crest to supply lunch today. So I have 100 box lunches showing up at 10:30, and then just through the conversation about the other things going on here, we decided I could also come down and check hearing.
What do you want women to take from today, out of today's event?
Well, I think just exactly what it's called. You are special, and every single one of them is unique and important.
Purses with toiletry items in them, hearing, we're gonna take pictures of them. We're just going to try to touch their lives. It's about them. They're special, and we want to show them that they're special. We want to give them something to make their heart a little lighter. We searched high and low through all the clothes that are donated. We picked the best, if not the brand new stuff. We washed and cleaned and scrubbed shoes so they looked new. We made contacts throughout the community to get things donated for these folks, and I'm so impressed with the city of Long Beach and how they do and are willing to help us with our project today.
Give me your eyes so I can see. Give me your eyes, Lord, give me your eyes so I can see. For everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity. Give me your heart for the broken hearted.